Gabby, Evan Kelly in a state of zen at the moment in this corner. Well, here we go. This is the main event of the evening. Trying to do my Euro impression of you know. Steve Taz McComb. Great to see him. A veteran of what? Is it 40 fights? Is it more
than this? This is his 50th fight tonight.
Oh, my word. Half century for Stevie Taz McComb. Great guy in the orange shirt.
Martial arts fighting for some people have had it for this.
Gavin Kelly from Next Gen AI with Rodney Moore in his corner in the black shorts.
And of course I have Dickie Larkin looking on closely here for one of his teammates beside me.
This is for the pro bantamweight title.
There you go. Put your gloves and we're on the way.
There you go, Reach. Stewie
McComb. Jam followed by a kick there by McComb.
McComb punching his way, kicking and punching his way in. That's his style. Good catch by Gavin Kelly.
Catches the kick and ragdolls into the ground. Oh, nice right hand by Kelly, and McComb has a nice little left counter himself.
Yeah, Kelly just a little off balance in that kick attempt. Steve McComb starts low, crouches, tries to explode upwards. Kelly just stay on the outside. Double jab,
double jab. Here we go.
Kelly
down. Home for that right hand there, just misses
the shot. Kelly with the height. Range, reach, advantage. And McComb with the takedown. Oh, that's well stuffed by Gavin Kelly.
So the sits in the floor there and got more butterfly in. What can McComb do from the bottom? What can Kelly do with top?
Oh, and Steve McComb has to be careful here.
He's looking, no grip in on a corner there, maybe he's looking.
Yes, he is.
There.
Steve McComb's got a submission of his own in the works here.
Just obstructed in and out. See, wait.
See, McComb's working for it. Gavin's just defending. Quite far from the cage at the moment, so there is room to work here.
Gavin, bring it right now. Bring me to the middle. Bring me to the middle.
And McComb is wanting this Kimura, isn't he?
Yeah,
no, well, it's just
right.
It's been neutralised by Kelly at the moment.
McComb used this as well for it. You can see he's trying to sweep as well. But also there's something with the Kimura. Looks like he's back over now.
Yeah, Gavin Kelly, just stay patient, stay on top.
Nice elbows from the bottom, baby. Keep your hands just keeping Kelly honest with these elbows. Saying, if you're going to leave your head there, I'll hit it.
Yeah, Kelly hasn't been able to posture up and fire anything down at McComb at all yet.
Yeah, McComb is just changing the hips a little there, maybe changing that arm. And nice elbows from the bottom there, still tells McComb.
Yeah, very short arm, Steve McComb, very powerful arms. And Kelly landed something there.
Yeah, nice elbows from the bottom, they're not falling at all from Kevin Kelly. He's improving his position there, get the head out of there. I mean, this is exactly what we were talking there. You're not winning the fight. Just because you're on bottom doesn't mean you're winning the fight. It is McComb doing all the attacking here, Stewart.
Absolutely. And Stephen McComb is showing at the moment he's trying to strike from the bottom. He's moving his hips. He's trying to look for arms. So Gavin Kelly is on top, but hasn't done anything from top, really.
Get that right elbow over the top now. Right elbow over the top now.
That's good advice. You may hear, may pick it up on the microphone there. Dick Larkin calling for elbows from Kelly from the top, just to turn the wrist over and land some elbows.
And then Stephen McComb having a little look. Gavin Kelly's right on.
And he's just holding that wrist, he is, just for the opportunity. Kelly aware of it, bringing the knee up to protect.
Advice from Rodney Moore to stand now for Gavin Kelly, but hasn't been able to. Eddie Marin letting him work. But there isn't a lot of work going on. I mean, there is work going on, obviously, no, but again, it's not the most exciting part to watch.
Again, you can see that both fighters are wary of what the other is doing. You can see Kelly's respecting the ground game of Steve Taz McComb.
What Kelly hasn't really tried to do is progressive.
The guard
position.
Is
he's remained in guard, and yeah. He hasn't tried to move his legs through at all.
Rodney Moore calling for him to stand up, and he's out there if he wants.
And finally, Kelly manages to posture up and lands a couple of punches on Steve McComb.
Come
with a backhand punch from the bottom.
There you go, right there you go. Kelly now stands up in his corner, so here we go.
Steve McComb with the takedown attempt, single now. He tried this at the start of the first, and he stuffed it. That's the position we ended up in. Can Steve McComb push it through? That's better work by Taz.
Looking for the toe. Kelly aware of it.
Elbow. Kevin Kelly just a bit slow to set anything off when he gets that top position. And
story of the round there was
pretty much. You know, two takedown attempts by McComb and got stuffed and then Kelly on top. But it's the top position, but not really doing an awful lot from it. And actually, as we said, and you were pointing out, McComb was firing in some elbows from the bottom, working his hips, looking for a Kimura. Difficult round to score, probably.
Yeah, again, we were talking earlier on one of the points about scoring from the bottom. If you're looking at the fight, you might think, yeah, well, Kevin Kelly's on top, he's in a dominant position. But McComb was landing elbows from the bottom, landing shots, threatening with Kimura. So what way do you score? Do you score the position or do you score the point scored? The shots landed, I should say, more so.
I'll see McComb just from Devil's Bite. I was going to call them Devil's Bite Team. Is that right? Am I saying it right? Devil's Bite Club?
I'm like Ron Burgundy, sure. It says DFC on my paper, so I say DFC.
All right, DFC it is.
Ron Burgundy.
Steve McComb, of course, broke his arm very badly in the fight in England and actually has a plate and several screws. I think it's his left arm. Happy to come back to combat. Very strong, well-conditioned man. 50th pro fight, and again, that's an incredible amount of professional MMA fights. Good shot by Gavin Kelly.
Nice uppercut on the inside there.
Oh, good front kick as well. Kelly strong enough to push McComb back, but we're in the same position we were in round one.
He's got one butterfly in there, and he sort of hooks the leg there to hold Kelly in the half guard. And Kelly's gonna look to work his way up into better position here. And
control his biceps, control his biceps.
I don't think Adrian Arnold will let him lie like this for too much longer down here.
Tangle up that leg, Gavin. Your right foot, there you go.
Again, he needs to be careful as he's pushing the foot down.
And Gavin Kelly now working into position. This is what we said in the round first round. Side control, right?
Big knee in there, big knee.
You can't want to be careful turning his back. He's giving the back. Kelly goes with him.
Trying to control the wrist of Gavin Kelly.
Where's that knee there, Gavin? Where's that knee?
He just repositioned himself there before. Looks like Kelly's going to try and roll into something here. Kelly's aware of it, rolls with him.
We're back in the half guard position, but Kelly now is doing some things from the top, even just through small punches.
Full mount position available here. If Kelly can just free that right leg, he has the left leg pushed down on McComb's own leg just to try and free it up. McComb's knock into recovery position.
McComb just rolling over. McComb maybe coming back to his feet now. McComb staying. Kelly controlling the neck of McComb now.
Possible dart choke on.
Yeah, he's trying to choke him.
He's got a roll and this looks good.
I think McComb's in a little bit of trouble here now.
He's let go of it.
Yes.
He's having a sort of crucifix position here, sure, he could start raining down heavy elbows here. Good work by McComb.
Yeah, McComb's sort of short arms and legs, difficult to control in these positions. He's able to get back into guard position. Now he's throwing up his hips. But Kelly landing shots from the top, some hammer fists on it. Again, looking maybe at the neck of McComb this time. Maybe able to take the back of McComb, possibly.
McComb's got to be careful, got to watch the neck here as he stands up. Kelly's all over it.
Gavin Kelly really controlling this round, much better than the first round.
He needs to sit in and get the hooks in. He's sort of... McComb is just torn into him here. He needs to be careful. He tries to roll. Kelly rides away. Very well, good work there by Kelly.
Yeah. Kelly all over McComb here.
Dominant in the second round here by Gavin Kelly. And this will be exhausting to Steve
McComb. Oh, there's a good knee. That knocks some wind out of Steve McComb. I don't care how fit you are. He is trying to soften up to see can he sneak an arm underneath the chin of McComb, maybe to look for the rear naked choke.
hold again, but again, Kelly aware and rolls with him and changes position to a side control back down there. So,
yeah, it's a good performance by Gavin Kelly right now.
This is a dominant performance here in the second round, so he's really stepping up.
Gum doesn't want to face that knee again. Here it might be coming in.
Gotta watch the neck there. McCollum won't reach and put in it. It should be safe. He's inside as well. I'm very careful holding on to that.
McCollum not quite sure what to do. Well, he's trying to maybe get back to his feet, or is he going to try and roll again?
Yes. Nice work by Gavin Kelly there again. He's looking at possible.
Another chunk position.
Just lost it again. Oh, great work by Kelly. Every time.
It's just relentless, isn't it? No, it's just relentless.
Him, yeah.
Not giving McCollum a second to breathe or to change, to sort of relax.
He's flowing with all McCollum's movements, and where McCollum tries to roll to a better position, Kelly's there to already be in the dominant position again.
And all McCollum is trying really is just to grab onto the wrist of Kelly and maybe threaten possibly a Kimura, but he hasn't threatened it this round. And Gavin Kelly again looking for a position where he could try to set up a choke on McCollum. Coming towards the end of the second round now.
There's a clap up. Again, that's really put a statement on this fight. Gavin Hand Kelly there. Andy Kelly was a fantastic second round. That you could even, you know, it was a 10-9, but you could see a reason for the 10-8. It was complete domination.
Complete domination, but no real fight ending threat, so it'll be a 10-9. Can't see it being 10-8, but yeah.
No,
that was
you struggle, but it. It'd be the most dominant 10-9 you could see, you know, it was basically all Gavin Kelly in that round.
Yeah, he found ways to work through the guard, but I think we highlighted that, didn't we? The first round he didn't try to move his knee, so he didn't try to improve his position, and then this time he did. And once he got into that side, or even in half guard, he was much more threatening.
You gotta wonder about the tank now, Stephen McCollum coming into the third round here. Because that type of work that Gavin Kelly done in the second round is gonna have McCollum exhausted. So it's gonna be interesting to see what McCollum can offer here.
Well, just 5 minutes left, but they're going for gold, so who can really lift it in these last 5 minutes? This is for the Clan Wars Bantamweight title.
A scooter rings around the Ramada Hotel.
So the seconds are removed. This is the final round then of Clan Wars 24. See McCollum breathing deeply. Gavin Kelly comes to meet him.
This is the tour around the crown. Your new lightweight champion, bantamweight champion.
We embrace, and here we go. Final round. See McCollum does look tired.
He looks heavy legged, all right.
But he can still punch. We know that. Okay, keeping his range. Okay, Steve McCollum shoots for the takedown. We've seen this before, and this is what happened. No, this could be different. But no, it isn't. Yeah. Gavin Kelly.
Nice work. Rolling again with McCollum. It just seems to be one step ahead each time. But good work from the bottom here by McCollum with elbows. Has him in the guard. And Kelly steps away.
And he wants it stood up. Kelly just backs away. Doesn't want to risk getting some. He's leading off with a jab. Again, just the range difference here, a big advantage for Gavin Kelly.
Nice kick there by McCollum. Kelly just grazed with an overhand right there. And McCollum sort of goes with a double leg, misses it, and jumps back into guard, lies back into his guard.
Every time, really, that he's gone for the takedown, this has pretty much resulted. Gavin Kelly is obviously aware that McCollum likes to shoot in. He's been able to get his heaviness through and push. Push McCollum back on his back, thinking about it.
Against that, losing the referee. Oh, just a miss with the hook there, and Kelly just from the pressure.
That's a good knee to the body there.
And
Steve McCollum is tired. That was a very good knee. And up the auto window to McCollum. McCollum looks very tired right now. The finish could be on for Kelly. Kelly can break this, scoot to the back now. I think McCollum is, I think he's running on fumes, as they say.
And again, now this time around. Kelly in this dominant position again against a tired fighter. Opportunities will arise, but mistakes through tiredness will avail, so will present himself, I should say. Gavin, I mean, you feel if Gavin Kelly was to land a few shots here, he's going to make the referee make a decision.
Well, it's just that right hand's keep being controlled by McCombe. That's kind of his one tactic. And now Kelly's hands are free again. And he's delivering punches to the side of McCombe's head. Just, he isn't going in to try to take the back, which is interesting.
Yeah, I was surprised with that, that he's not stepping, trying to get hooks in here.
Maybe he just doesn't want to give McCombe a chance to roll, maybe grab a leg.
You can see now again, he's trying to fish that hand under the neck again, maybe looking for Darce again. I don't know why the old veteran is, he knows what's coming though, so.
No, of course he does.
Rolls again, but Kelly once again rolls with him and again is in the dominant position here. This is very similar to round number two. He's fished it through to Darce, is possibly oh, on here.
There's a choke here.
McCombe
has top. Gavin Kelly with the victory, the Darce choke. To lift the bantamweight title, and Stephen McCombe is absolutely exhausted. Both men embrace, look each other in the eyes and say, well done, mate. Gavin Kelly, terrific performance, improved as each round went on, and finally secured the victory and becomes the Clan Wars bantamweight title holder. Well done, Gavin Kelly.
Continued support. Have a safe night.